Welcome back everybody to Altcoin Daily. In today's video, Morgan Stanley doubles down on their Bitcoin exposure. We will show you the exact date, where and when they bought in. Ethereum sees huge protocol milestone. We'll talk about what this means. Cardano, potential red flag. You will ultimately have to be the judge, but a major exchange is talking about delisting ADA in 2022. I will share the information with you. Regal Cinema, another major movie chain, has just announced they're accepting cryptocurrency, more cryptocurrencies than even AMC. I'll share with you which altcoins, major metaverse news, and even a specific altcoin partnering with Macy's and releasing NFTs for their Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. I will tell you which altcoin this is. Before we get into it, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We drop one video every day, keeping you informed, demystifying the cryptocurrency market. Smash the like button, support the channel, and let's jump in. Before we get into recent news, let's take stock regarding where we are in the Bitcoin bull cycle, particularly compared to 2017, compared to 2013, particularly looking at the two-week RSI, looking at the price chart consolidation, the shape of the market, looking at the Fibonacci levels. And you can see for yourself, I know it doesn't feel like it, but there is much evidence indicating that we are here on the two-week time frame. And you know what? It didn't really feel like it the other two cycles either. So bullish, bearish. I'm personally bullish, but let me know your thoughts in the comments below. But again, if you're not bullish, I say to you, are you closing your eyes to what is going on in the world? Point in case, Morgan Stanley has increased their Bitcoin exposure. Despite recent market conditions, investment banking giant Morgan Stanley seems bullish on Bitcoin. They used to FUD it. They used to call it a scam or a Ponzi. Now they continue to buy. The details are this. Tuesday, SEC filings reveal that Morgan Stanley has increased its indirect Bitcoin exposure through several of its funds. So this is only something we know because they're forced to report this publicly. Imagine all the private entities and the private individuals who don't have to disclose. Anyways, so when did they buy? Well, over the June 30th to September 30th period, the firm acquired more than 2.6 million Grayscale Bitcoin Trust shares worth around $118 million. At present, the firm holds approximately 6.6 million GBTC shares worth over $300 million at current market prices. So just so you fully understand when they bought at some of the best times to buy in this recent dip. They began buying here. Perhaps they caused this pump or they caused some of this pump and they continued buying here, perhaps leading into this pump. So when you were scared, if you were scared, they were buying. Speaks volumes. And again, I say to you, open your eyes as to what is going on in the world. Citibank is hiring over 100 people for its digital asset and crypto division. Probably nothing, I guess, right? If you're a bear. How about this? We already know that AMC accepts Bitcoin, Litecoin, Ethereum, and Dogecoin, while Regal Cinema is aping AMC. They now accept Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin for movie tickets. However, they accept a lot more than that. Regal is the latest movie theater chain to accept cryptocurrency payments, and it has a longer list of coins and tokens than AMC. So what are some of the biggest coins that they're accepting? Well, they're accepting stable coins. They're accepting Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin, Litecoin. They're also accepting Basic Attention, Cosmos, Chainlink, and others. So this is great. This is a big deal. I like this. In addition to that, Macy's has partnered with an Ethereum-based altcoin and is launching an Ethereum NFT collection based on the Thanksgiving Day Parade. The details are this. This is perfect to talk about with your families. The department store behind the eponymous Thanksgiving Day Parade in New York is giving away 9,500 Ethereum NFTs to celebrate its 95th year of presenting the event. 10 ultra-rare versions of the NFTs are being auctioned and have already generated 41,700 in bids. Macy's says it will begin giving away the free NFTs Thanksgiving, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, November 25th, Now, as a cryptocurrency investor, this next part excites me the most. Macy's NFT Ethereum-based tokens are on the Polygon network. If you follow the people that I follow, you already knew this. Polygon tweeted out, "Welcome to the Web3 space and the Polygon ecosystem, Macy's." The Macy's NFT Ethereum-based tokens on the Polygon network donate 10% of every secondary market sale to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. So this is going to a good cause. It's the same as when artists set up their NFTs to send them commission each time their art is resold, except the commission now is going to Make-A-Wish Foundation. Also, all of the proceeds from the Ultra Rare collection will go to the foundation. So this is huge for the boomers, guys. Boomers at Thanksgiving will love this story. And as crypto investors and speculators and enthusiasts, we love it. I mean, cryptocurrency, NFTs, Bitcoin, Ethereum has entered into the mainstream by far this year. NFT wins Word of the Year award from Collins Dictionary. Crypto and Metaverse were also highlighted in Collins Dictionary shortlist. Major milestone for Ethereum. We've been reporting this to you since the very beginning. 1 million Ethereum worth have now been burnt since the implementation of EIP 1559 in August. And for exact details, ultrasound.money is a great resource. We can see that we're at a current burn rate of 6.26. I remember when it was a 3 burn rate, then a 5 burn rate. This is only heating up, and we can even see the burn leaderboard. National Football League all day. Dapper Labs unveils football version of NBA Top Shot for the NFL. The flow-based NFT platform is set to launch this season, this NFL season, with the first packs featuring some big names. If you remember the wild success of NBA Top Shot, non-crypto people creating crypto wallets, buying, trading, selling gifts of the highlights of the latest games. This introduces so many people who would otherwise not be into crypto, them starting to understand receiving in a cryptocurrency wallet, sending in a cryptocurrency wallet. Obviously, this is going to be huge for adoption as a whole, particularly if you are an American football fan. Now, it's not all sunshine and roses. I'm curious your thoughts about these next two stories, SHIB and then Cardano. For SHIB, SHIB is slumping as large holders take profits. So although retail traders' interest in the token seems to be remaining strong, an increasing number of wallets with significant holdings have reduced their SHIB positions. And this is why we say trading meme coins is risky, and you don't want to be the last to sell, right? Looks like SHIB is finally breaking the bearish triangle. Now, cryptocurrency goes in ebbs and flows all the time. It is possible that SHIB eventually breaks above this all-time high. It is very possible. But, you know, people are into SHIB to take profits, along with all of cryptocurrency. That's not controversial. Tell me your thoughts on Shiba Inu in the comments below, and tell me your thoughts on this. This surprised me. eToro to delist Cardano by 2022 for US users due to regulatory concerns. The move surprised some users, as ADA has not typically been on regulators' radars as of late. So the details are this. In a statement released to customers Tuesday, Israeli-based cryptocurrency exchange eToro announced it would delist Cardano and Tron for United States customers by the end of the year. Now, Tron, not so much in the conversation this cycle, but Cardano certainly is. This move came as a surprise to some, as ADA has not been traditionally associated with regulatory troubles. In context, tokens like Ripple's XRP, whose creators are currently engaged in an ongoing lawsuit with Securities and Exchange Commission, or SEC, that's seen delistings. Privacy coins like Monero, which some people feel could easily be used for illicit purposes, are being delisted. So here's the thing. I understand why they're delisting Tron. It's centralized, it's not gaining that much utility. I understand why American companies delist XRP. It's centralized and it's going through legal troubles, and obviously we're just waiting for the SEC case to clear up. I understand why privacy coins like Monero are being delisted. But Cardano, honestly, I don't think Cardano deserves this. I think Cardano has a blue skies path forward. And ultimately, as of now, I don't think many other exchanges are going to do this, considering how many exchanges currently list Cardano, and it's only getting more distributed, and it's only, you know, gaining more traction as it is fully competitive with Ethereum now that smart contracts are enabled. But anyways, tell me what you think. I just wanted to share with you the news, Cardano holders. We try and keep things real on this channel. We can point out the good things. You know, Metaverse frenzy sends Decentraland to another all-time high, along with Sand, along with so many lower cap Metaverse coins. And we can talk about the bad things like we just talked about, you know, SHIB and the Cardano news. Hey, major Metaverse news. We talked about Nike the other day. Well, now Adidas tweeted out, we've partnered with Coinbase, probably nothing. Hey, in the Metaverse, your kicks can never get scuffed. You can kind of see the way the future is heading. And that's pretty much it for me today, guys. Hope you have a fantastic Thanksgiving. I hope I was able to keep you informed in this video. If you're new, feel free to subscribe. We cover daily news on a daily basis. Give the video a like and let me know if you got value in the comments. Let me know if you watched to the end. I will be responding to some comments. I'll see you tomorrow.